Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this is many a true note, and welcome to Alekhine's Gun. Sorry, I've probably just mispronounced that. I don't know how it's pronounced. The game will tell me how that's pronounced, and I'll correct myself soon. So this is Alekhine's Gun, and this is a very curious game that I feel I'm very excited by. I've been watching this for a while, but I also feel kind of sorry for, because as far as I can tell from reading all the documentation around it, the entire ethos and idea behind Alekhine's Gun appears to be, hey, Hitman Blood Money was a great game, but Absolution wasn't so good. Let's make a game that's like Hitman Blood Money, but like set in the Cold War, because loads of people liked Hitman Blood Money, so that'll go really, really well. Which was a fantastic idea, and then the new Hitman started emerging, and all of a sudden that felt a lot like Hitman Blood Money did. And then to slightly compound matters, if the current Steam page is to be believed, Alekhine's Gun actually launches on March the 11th. Which is the exact same day the new Hitman comes out, which is ballsy. I'll give them that. You have to have balls as big as 47's big bald head in order to actually launch a sort of Hitman-ish game on the same day the new Hitman comes out. But alright, I'll give them bravery, and I've liked the look of what I've seen so far in the trailers. So, let's have a little look at this, shall we? November 1963. And we're in, I'm guessing that's that's America. That'd be New York, right? That'll be Empire State Building in the background, I'm guessing.
President Kennedy was shot today. An hour later, my family was murdered. I have nothing left. No future to live for. Those who shook my hands and swore on the Constitution to defend our country betrayed us all. 23 years in the CIA, and this is where I end up. What kind of man fails to protect his wife and son? I'm so sorry, Sean. And you, Barbara? There's no sense in asking for forgiveness. There's no sense in imagining what I could have done differently.
Well, it was a short game, but I liked it. It had a good plot arc. I mean, I'm guessing that wasn't Alekhine, unless that there was his gun and someone else is going to pick it up and use it, and it's actually going to be the story of a gun as it's passed. Actually, that's a really interesting framing device. Someone should do that.
Not so long ago, I was asked about how this story began. And I remembered not the Caribbean crisis, not the hydrogen bomb, not even the conference in Yalta that divided the world in two. Everything started much earlier for me. In 1943, I received a mission from HQ. I had to infiltrate the Bergernes fortress in Norway. I first met Vincent Rambaldi there, in Bergen. That was where everything started.
So I'm guessing that there is Alekhine, but we're going back a good 20-odd years into his past. And here we are, our first mission. Sneak inside the castle. So sneak into the castle, use the front gates to infiltrate the castle. Every 2 weeks, a vehicle containing supplies comes that passes minimum checks. Security in courtyard is minus several guards and single patrols. Then we have to eliminate Martin Fichtner. And obviously, if he is a Nazi officer, there's nothing that makes you feel perfectly comfortable with being an assassin better than being in World War II and going after Nazis. They are the killing world's freebies. You can kill as many as you want without any moral qualms whatsoever. So, what do we know about him? He has a younger brother. Oh, stop trying to humanize him. He's a Nazi. So, SS officer in the Gestapo. Yep, definitely a freebie kill there. Ah, of course, because right now I'm probably working for Russian intelligence. And indeed, this chap up in Finland, because of course Russia, the very beginning of World War II, I believe 1941, Russia tried to invade Finland, but it went very, very badly, because at that point the Russian military machine was incredibly backward and not really kind of cut out for war at all. Which interestingly is thought to be one of the reasons Hitler actually invaded the USSR, because he saw how badly they'd done in Finland. But between Finland and the Nazi invasion of Russia, Stalin had been rapidly militarizing and massively improved the military. Not like a spectacular amount, but enough to hold back the Nazis. Interesting little bit of historical detail anyway. So in Finland, therefore, it looks like this Nazi had managed to get hold of various bits of Russian intelligence, and we're going to need to destroy those. Fine. And another doctor, a Nazi eugenicist, also needs to go down. All right, lovely. Oh, and all very blood money, so I get a proper little equipment screen where I can, as new missions go along, use what I'm guessing is reputation points to unlock new weapons, including straight away being able to choose for my basic pistol, my silver baller, sorry, my Tokarev, whether I want to carry in one or two of them. You actually get a choice whether you'd like to carry in one or two of them. So yeah, doubled up silver ballers or single silver. And I don't mind. I don't mind them. Like, doing the big kind of takeoff of Hitman Blood Money. It's great that someone did. It's just a shame they did it at this point when the new Hitman's already done. It's even got a little symbol kind of on the handle there, just like the silver ballers do. It's glorious. And for the moment, this here gun doesn't have a silencer. Okay, but it's accurate, it's noisy, and it's not got great range. And as time goes on, I could unlock various other guns, including sniper rifles. Nice. Or if I want to, I could just take in a little submachine gun. And I'm also carrying in a combat knife, some chloroform, and a garrote, obviously. Chloroform, fiber wire, knife, and my silver bowlers. Alright, that seems like a perfectly good loadout. And so here we are inside Alekhine's gun, infiltrating a castle. So it all feels very much like, yeah, it feels very Hitman Blood Money already. So you've kind of got a sneaking mode or a walking mode. You've kind of got all your weapons are on the D-pad. So yeah, the chloroform, the combat knife, the thing. Where's the... I swear I had a gun. I brought a gun with me, but maybe I'm not allowed to get it out just yet because we're kind of in a training mission right now. And then we've got kind of ourselves, yeah, we've got our targets up on a compass that looks very much like the compass from Hitman 2 Silent Assassin, actually. And then if I've... Oh, I've got a whistle. I've actually got a little distraction whistle. Kind of like Assassin's Creed Syndicate, in fact. All right, that's a nice thing to have, actually. Kind of like the coin. But instead of the coin being like your direction, instead you're kind of drawing enemies to you. All right, anything else particularly crucial here? So you pick out a weapon. With left trigger, you pull it out. And then you use it with right trigger. All right, fine. And then we've got... And this bit's a bit more interesting. So we've got a couple of guards over there. But I have got... my instinct mode. So you can activate instinct mode using RB. Using this mode will help you orientate around enemies and find level tips. So using weapons in this mode will help you with aiming. You can see the enemies near you, orientation and field of view on the compass. White means that you're hidden from them. Yellow means the enemy is watching you. Red means the enemy is watching you perform a dangerous or suspicious action, such as entering a prohibited area, carrying a weapon, lockpicking, etc. So those guys are now kind of, yeah, like that. And I can see their field of vision. So if I come out of that, okay, so I only get the radar when I'm in my instinct mode. Do I have a limit on my instinct mode or... Can't see one. Seems to be as it should be. So, based on that, if I just go this way, I actually avoid those guys. Ah, but there's another one. So, yeah, that guy's cone is facing that way. That guy's cone is facing that way. And, ooh, and there's presumably someone up top somewhere because I can clearly see there's... Ooh, yeah, someone in that direction. Oh, sorry, my mistake. Down in the bottom left there, around my little kind of atom symbol, that is my instinct meter. So instinct's back, but it's kind of good instinct like it is in the new Hitman, not bad instinct like it was in Absolution, where the only thing instinct does is flag enemies. Though I quite like their field of view, kind of, yeah, kind of like cone field of view, which has never really been a thing in Hitman, is a thing in this game. So probably best to not go that way, but instead go around this way. Tutorial. Move south to the next checkpoint. Check the guide point on the compass for directions. All right, hang on. Where is my map or compass? Oh, south. South is that direction. Fine. Then I've got myself... Ooh! I've got a proper old school Blood Money or Hitman 2 style map, which... I'm playing this on normal, by the way. I kind of felt like I wanted to be on normal rather than easy straight away, so... Oh, wait, hang on. Ooh, does that mean there's a door? I could actually go through... Ooh, I could go through a door in here. Yeah, you know, I think I'm fine to be not creeping all of the time. It feels a bit more like actually almost like Hitman 2, because the movement's quite slow. Yeah, you kind of move around quite slow. I think I do actually have a... Do I have a run? Oh, yes, I do have a run. I have a run on... If I hold down A, I can actually run. So, therefore, I've got kind of a little kind of go through here. And then... Ooh, is that a light switch I can actually use? Switch light, use cover. Oh my goodness, yes, it's proper light switches. Get yourself in darkness, and I'm guessing light and darkness affect visibility. Very cool, but nothing actually in here by the looks of it. There's a little cover system as well, by the way, which is quite good. So yeah, you can kind of go into hidden right there, which kind of means that if you don't want to be spotted, you can go into an area and kind of go into cover quite easily, which is quite good. I don't know if you can move while you're in cover. Hang on. I'll kind of go over here and I'll check that in a second. And also, I'll stop clicking in the left trigger button, because that is my whistle and draw attention to yourself button, which is probably a button I shouldn't be clicking. So go into cover. And yeah, you can creep around cover. That's pretty good. Can't go around corners in cover, though, which is fine. But yeah, if you ever want to kind of be sure that you're okay, you can do it like that. Then you can just quickly check on your enemy's visibility with your instinct meter. So everything is fine there. Ah, well, we've got a bit of a problem here, which is it does rather look like there's going to be someone that sees me over here. Hang on. Who's going to see me over here? Oh, yeah. Oh, hang on. Whoever is... Okay, so there's a guard there. We can probably work around them. So is there a guard in this here box or something? Hang on, we need to figure this out. Ah, okay, I'm guessing we're going to be tutorialized for a silent takedown here. So select the garrote with the D-pad, then LT to raise it, which I've already done. And then once it's raised, press RT to choke a bloke. And then, because we're all in third person, oh, we can just get this guy. Ooh, you're a Nazi. I don't feel even remotely bad about this. And then, you better be going over. Oh, yes, and then, there we go. So when you get close enough, it goes into a little cutscene, which actually is not a bad idea, because when that happens, obviously, that means that the animation can't go a bit wonky, because it's kind of in a bit of a pre-rendered mode. So I should probably pick up the body and move it to somewhere. So picking up is putting over shoulder, and then I move quite slowly. And then don't forget to hide dead bodies. You can use wardrobes, big boxes, or other special places. I'm going to put you in a special place. So put you down. Let's just use your soldier's clothing just to make sure that, just on the off chance. There we are. And a little cutaway during that moment, so to kind of disguise the fact there's no real animation. Now we pick up the body. Now do we have to just quietly... I'm just going to quickly check on those guys, actually. Are they both facing... away. Yeah, we're okay for the minute. Just put him in a box. So we'll put him in this here box, which was suggested would be safe. I even look a little bit like Ford Savage. You've kind of got that slight kind of grim grumpiness to you, which is quite good. All right, so now I'm here. I can go up into this door. Oh, I can open it. Or you can peek through the keyhole. Of course you can. Ah, and here is a wardrobe I could use to have hidden that body as well. So we've got a wardrobe there. And upstairs, meanwhile, we've got what looks like to me a Nazi officer or something. So we'll just sneak behind him nice and quick. And just get him down. I'm not sure what he's got and whether he's got like the uniform I want or not. So I think right now I'm a soldier. And he's got, ooh, he's got a Walther P-38. That's one of the ones I've got. So yeah, just like kind of the Hitmans of old. When you get someone and you've got multiple things, you can kind of go through the options. So may as well get his gun. And pick up his body as well. Actually, why do I not want his body? Do I not want his disguise? Or is his disguise actually just like the same as I'm wearing, just a slight variant thereupon? So put him down. Do I not want his disguise at all? Apparently I don't. I think maybe I'm the same rank as him, just wearing slightly different clothing or something. I don't know. Maybe the Nazis are a bit fashion conscious. Maybe this is just an alternate way to get a disguise in case you snuck past rather than killing that first guy. Fine. But now at least I do actually have a gun. Well, I swear I had a gun already, but never mind. And then as you can see there, with a gun, you can get that out. And then if you go into instinct mode while you're... I wonder if it's slow-mo. Either case, we've got ourselves a disguise. May as well find out how it works at this point. Can I at this point simply blend in with absolutely everyone? Are they all fine with me? Hello. Are we all soldiers? Yes, we're absolutely fine. The suspicion meter is like a big circle that appears on screen, so if you do anything wrong, like trespass, like you can see it going up, but until it fills up entirely, you're not in trouble. So you've kind of got like a little bit of an opportunity to get out of the way if you mess everything up. All right, so that's all fine. And are you fine as well? Yeah, we're all fine with each other. Lovely. So I've got a disguise, and now I can just walk in. So that's the initial courtyard passed. And my objective one is to, yep, infiltrate the area, so sneak inside the castle. And looks like that's going to happen right in front of me. Though I'm guessing if I want to, I could have just, you know, kill all these guys and just go in my normal clothing if I were to wish to. So that's good. So the danger scale, exclamation mark, and the scale around the top part of the screen displays the total suspicion value of your actions from the enemy's point of view. The bigger the scale, the higher the risk of failure. If you get into a visibility zone of an enemy who is potentially dangerous to you or considers your action suspicious, the danger scale will grow. Okay, so does that mean... Well, who's going to consider me suspicious? Are you going to consider me suspicious? Are you? No, everything's fine. Then there's just a worker there as well, who's apparently all fine too. Oh, am I being considered a little bit suspicious? Am I allowed to just walk through this door? Maybe I need to keep my distance from certain people. In either case, let's just close the door. And we have snuck inside this castle. Lovely. And, oh yeah, just like Blood Money, you can cycle between the different maps. So right now I'm on the first floor of this here castle. And my new primary target is to eliminate Martin Fitchner. Alright, looks like the easiest way to get to him will either be just kind of loop around the outside of what I'm in, or if I were to go upstairs, and potentially if I were to look at the second floor here, yeah, it looks like actually I might be better off just going upstairs and seeing if I can loop around the top, because then there'll be less guards that way. So is there a staircase up here? And if so, am I allowed to use it? Don't mind me, Heil Hitler. So up to the top floor, head round here, and now we are, yep, we're up here. That is just a big courtyard in the middle. Let's just see if we can loop round the top. Open this door, hopefully no one thinks this is at all suspicious. Now if we go over to the second floor, oh, someone's moving at speed. Why is someone, oh no, that looked like it was running, but no, I think they're just walking. I think everything's fine. Oh, someone's a bit suspicious of me, someone's a bit suspicious. Why are they suspicious of me? Should I not be here? A normal soldier's not supposed to be here. And then we've got... Aha! We've got ourselves Martin Fitchner down there. That'll be him at the table. Are you going to be suspicious of me? I really hope not. So I guess I could, theoretically, just straight up shoot him up here. But as he's sitting at a dining room table, strikes me that there's probably going to be a much cleverer way of doing it. For example, is he by any chance sitting directly underneath a chandelier? Not quite directly. Not enough that I think it's necessarily the right thing to do right now anyway. So I could just put a bullet in him, but there's a lot of guards around. Dinner table strikes me as poisoning as an interesting solution. Let's go down and see if I can find anything more clever to do to him downstairs. He's relatively well guarded right now. Also, may as well check what rules are in play for running. Am I fundamentally more suspicious if I'm running than if I'm walking? Are you more suspicious of me if I'm running? No, good. Running appears to be perfectly allowed. Ah, and there's a little spiral staircase down here. Gets me down onto the foot. Oh, I'm not supposed to be here. Is a normal soldier not supposed to be going? Oh, yes, a normal soldier is not supposed to be going into that room. Fine, back away. That guy's a little suspicious of me. All right, fine. Those guys are potentially, I don't know, SS officers. Oh, maybe I'm allowed to just walk past them as long as I kind of do it fairly quick and easy. Courtyard out here. One. Oh, hello. Yes, yes, whatever you just said. I really probably should have learned German before I attempted to do this infiltration mission. So use the environment or whistle. Radios or light switches can be used to distract guards. Okay, so if I want to distract a guard, I could do that nice and easily by using, yes, whistling light switches to draw their attention or turning radios on and off. All makes sense, yes. The question is, how many guards do I necessarily want to be able to distract? And how many of these people are wearing different uniforms to me? If I just kind of quickly walk past you. No, I'm fine. I'm fine. I perfectly believe that, like, blonde, blue-eyed people are definitely, like, the best people. The best people. Absolutely no doubt in my mind on that. Let's see what we can do here. Can I just walk straight past these people if I just do it nice and quick and act like I own the place? Or is this just a room I'm not allowed in? No, as long as I move quickly and don't stand by any one person for too long, nobody minds me. Stay out of their way. Stay hidden. Oh, hang on. Where's the bloody target gone? He's over there now. Oh, there he is. Okay, so he goes for a bit of... Oh, he goes for a wander. And right now, my target is walking away. And are you about to step? You go outside sporadically. That could be of use. Oh dear, I may have just caused a slight small alert there, which is I hopped over the balcony, and I've accidentally got myself into an area where I'm not sure I'm necessarily even supposed to be. A little medical wing here, and the door, the other side, is locked. Alright, well this is as good a time as any to learn about lockpicking then. So rotate lockpick. Oh, I need to actually find a flipping... Oh, flip. It's actually a proper little find a matching. Is that right? Alright, so first one match, and then you need to match the second one. Find one that matches. So it actually takes... No, that's not right. There you go. And now that is open. Is opening what was once a locked door a crime? No, it is not. Or at least if it is, no one saw me do it. Alright. I think there might be two different classes of soldier here. I'm just like a basic soldier, but I could do with being one of those fancy lads in the little kind of SS uniforms or whatever. If I could be one of those guys, I feel like I might have better access to the world. So I need to find one of these lads in the fancy black and separate him off. Three in this room, so that's not going to work. Ah, but if I had left from the first room... I enter this what looks like a much more deserted section, including, ooh, down to a basement. A basement? What's down in the basement? Ooh, okay, curious. Curious now, so we've got all sorts of stuff down here. So now I'm on the basement level. Basement. Looks like there's very little here except potentially a way out. Okay, this might be a good escape later, but it feels like for now there's actually no one. Ooh, there is a ladder here. Okay, right, so the basement... has a ladder. Where does this lead up to? This leads up to... Oh, is this the... Where am I now? Oh, I'm outside the walls. I'm outside the walls. So now I'm the other side. Okay, so now I'm outside on the other side of the castle. But my first target doesn't actually come out this way. He's staying inside the castle. So don't need to worry about that for now. But this is one other way to escape the area. Though the door that leads outside there, that door there... That is actually a door. I know where that is. All right, fine. Don't worry about that just yet, though. Ooh, nice slidey down ladders. Do that at speed. Love it. So, yeah, you're a basic soldier like me, so you don't become suspicious of me. Fine. It's only the SS officers that become suspicious of me. So I've got to find myself, an SS officer in order to get his costume off him. Because I believe only SS officers are allowed out into this courtyard. So when I stepped out there a minute ago, I was shooed out immediately by the SS. You're a basic soldier. You're not going to be worried by me. Where's the lads in black who don't have... yes, you're one of them. You're on your own. Here's one, too. Fine. So if I could just... And you are... I don't even know who you are. Am I allowed to go into this room at the back here? Do you mind me going through this room at the back here? I don't know what this is. Open the door. Okay, that's just a staircase down. Fine. And there's radio equipment here. Don't mind me, I'm just trashing your place. Yeah, that's right. Screw you if you wanted to sit down. And we've got a black cap guy here who's watching me. Can I walk through this door? Officers only. All right, yes. Definitely important that we get out into an officer's uniform as soon as possible in that case. So I suspect potentially up on the second floor here, this guy might actually be the most isolated officer. Now, if I were to hit this light switch and lure him down... Aha! I've distracted that guy with the light switch. Oh, no, I'm never going to be able to pick the lock in time, though. Right, okay. I'm guessing this is all happening in real time. No, walk away, walk away, walk away, walk away. I'm definitely not... Don't worry, I'm not picking that lock. Not picking that lock. Okay, so I could be able to potentially get through that door if I could just be fast enough... Lock picking. Oh, that's going to take some practice. So let's get to know our target. Our target enjoys having a nice bit of food and drink. Enjoys going through that door and then heading into the... Ooh. That is his private medical area. Right there. And as always, the doctor isn't around. He goes into a private medical area straight after he's had his meal. No one else is in there. And after he's gone into his private medical area, he goes to get himself some fresh air in the courtyard outside. So the moment where we want to actually grab him will be after He has his meal and goes into the private medical area. Oh, no, don't be suspicious of me. I'm fine. I'm a totally normal Nazi. I'm totally kind of, you know, pro-Hitler. Like we all say, Heil Hitler. Sorry, my mistake. And as for accessing that medical facility, well, that one is actually pretty simple. We stumbled across it earlier. Either you could lockpick this door here that I've already lockpicked from the other side if you were quick on the lockpick, or you could hop over this thing here in order to get out and into the... Ow, that's a bit of my health gone. Never mind. So inside the medical facility that we get to from the stairs up top... Poison. Yes. What else we got? Syringe. What can we do? Now I need to... Oh, wait. The poison I've picked up. Poison could go in food. Just let me walk in. No, it's fine. I'm definitely supposed to be in there. It's fine. I've just got this here poison. This here poison that's... The question is the poison... Is that on my things? No, it's not. Now just let me walk over to the food. Food. Pour poison into drink. Go. And then... Oh, I shouldn't have been seen doing that. Okay, gotta be a bit careful. Unlike in the new Hitman, pouring poison into something is bad. So this here is exactly what the instinct mode is for. Activate my instinct mode. Now know when I'm seen or not. Oh, no, now I'm being seen. Right, hang on. Walk away from that. Don't panic. And I believe I know the right opening, in fact, because after this guy goes to the medical facility and then walks away, I believe his two guards follow him for a bit, but when he goes outside for a cigarette, they return to this position. So all I've got to do is wait for him to stand up and then go to the medical facility, check in with it, or potentially while he's checking in with it, and then after he leaves, they will follow him as far as the door before returning to this position. Then there'll be no one left in this room, but that guy who circles around the back of those bookcases all the time, and then we will be absolutely golden. All right, up he gets, heads back towards medical. The guy over there, he's the one I need to keep an eye on. So one of the guards leaves right now and follows him to the medical wing, which is just there on the right. He'll go in, see there's no doctor, leave again. That guy starts making his journey, presumably towards the door at this point. Yep, here we go. This all works. You start making your journey over in that direction. Meanwhile, the scientist himself, or I can't remember what you are, you're some sort of SSE person, you're a bad person anyway, now starts moving with this guard. Perfect. This then has to be the right time. Yep, pour the wine, pour the poison in. This is the exact moment. Okay, I think I just got away with that. The poison's in the drink. And while he was suspicious of me for a second, he saw me like vaguely standing near the drink. He didn't see enough to panic. Lovely. Now, probably a good second step will be don't be anywhere bloody close to the guy when he actually drinks the poison. Instead, observe it from the second floor. I tell you what, this has actually got like more of an actual old school Hitman feel than the new Hitman game. The new Hitman game is relatively, from what I've experienced at least from the beta, because obviously that's all I've experienced so far, but the new Hitman feels quite generous. This feels slightly more old school tough Hitman. Yeah, quite a brutal Hitman game where you really need to like be watching and understanding everyone's movement patterns quite intimately if you actually want to assassinate them in a quite effective way and not just do it by murdering everyone, which I'm assuming is still, as always, an option. We're in a nice safe position to just watch and laugh. I suspect we are. That's right, you have a nice drink. You have a lovely drink there. Does taste a bit strange, he says. And now is he going to go to the medical lab by any chance? He's heading over there. Turns to the right, heads into the medical lab, and does he die quietly in there with nobody watching? Because if so, that'd be perfect. Objective complete. Martin Fitchner is dead. Beautiful. And I believe nobody even knows about it. Swing the camera around. With him dead, officer's clothing, nice and easy. Now pick up the body. Do you have anything else good on you? Actually, before we put you in the cupboard, do you have anything else good on you? Key to the room. Yep, fine. And a gun. Fine. Now pick up the body and shove it in this here cupboard. There's only one body per cupboard. Hide the body. In it goes. In you go. And yep, he's now closed. Though I can get it back out again later if I want to. Beautiful. So now I am an officer. So, new objectives. And I'm guessing now I'm an officer, I can go past that, I can go past that officer's only door. I ran into it. Get out of the way, scum. I'm the SS or the Gestapo or the I don't know what I am. I'm something important. You better be about to bloody salute me.
Heil Hitler!
That's better. Now I'm allowed in here. Perfect. And what is in this here room? I'm guessing one of my gypsies is straight ahead of me. I think that's the magnetic film that's like the evidence I need to destroy. It's in this here room. Is anyone else in here? Nope, all on my own. This is nice private quarters here. Ah, we've got ourselves a safe. Fine. Well, as far as I can tell, no one else comes into this room. So I'm nice and safe to pick this lock. Oh, this one's complicated apparently. Right, how does this work then? You're actually properly turning the thing. Right, I see. And now once that one's in place, you switch the other one round. But not before you've got to make sure you don't miss. Where's the big one? Aha. Oh, and then now round back the other way to get the final one in. It's quite fiddly. Open up. Lovely. So now I've got... Ooh, more poison. Okay, so if I had snuck in here first by using the light switch to distract the guy then picking the lock, I could have got poison from here. And this is arguably... this is a safer lock pick because no one comes this way. Destroy the tape. That just needs to be burnt, I believe. There we go. Burnt tape. Beautiful. Russian intelligence destroyed. Now, while I'm actually here, anything else good? Ah, something over here. What's this? Permit for entering prison. Got the feeling I'll be needing one of them. Lovely. Then anything else good in here? I like, the new instinct that just kind of flags stuff of interest. That's very, very good. As well as I like the fact that you only get the little mini radar when you're doing that. That's actually kind of cool. Huh? Says someone. But fortunately, I believe now nobody's suspicious of me, right? Because by standard Hitman rules, I am the only person who is, like, the lead SS guy. So therefore, no one's part of my faction or anything like that. So therefore, I can just go wherever the hell I want. Beautiful. Let's just, in that case, head for the door. Far side of the dining room. Everyone just does a quick Nazi salute at me as I walk past. And now I can just head outside and go to the prison. There we are. So there's a door outside here. Beautiful. Out we go. And I believe the prison is one of these big old buildings. How do I get up to it? Yes, here we go. It's this big old building they've converted into a prison. Ooh, though I'm more interested in the fact that there's a tower over here. Am I allowed to go into this tower? No, I'm not. That's a big disappointment. So yeah, let's go over to the map. That building over there on the south is just a fairly kind of boring, uninteresting, just like a little place presumably where you can hide bodies. This building at the front is the prison, so I just need to go around to the prison here. And this building, I need the prison permit to enter. No one's suspicious of me because I'm the officer, which is good news. So I guess I could do this dress as anything. As long as you've got a permit, you're allowed to go wherever the hell you want. So now I've got the permit, and everyone's fine with me. Beautiful. Close the door. Now we are in the prison. Ah, so you guys like the prison workers. That's what you guys are dressed as. Let's get into the prison. So we've got a storeroom straight ahead of us. Open that door. Fine. And then we've got, a changing room. So a good place to store bodies or potentially get ourselves a new... Yeah, we could get ourselves a new disguise here. Ooh, could this window be? No, that window's not open. Okay, so this is just a place to store some bodies, I'm guessing. Indeed. Aha! We've got... Oh, you're an officer too. Right, officers do recognise other officers by the looks of it. So people in pointy hats, be careful of them. Got it. So my objective now is to get up to and murder one more person who's another floor up. So just sneak around the back of this guy. Ooh, whoever that is, he met an unfortunate fate, didn't he? Got a bit of space around here to hide. If I want to hide from the officer, then let him go. Where are you going? Fine, I'll just walk straight past you. I think I can just walk past you fast enough. I'm assuming on the high difficulty, you have to use, like, cover a lot more in order to not be seen. Light and shadow seems to make a difference as well, by the way, which I quite like. But as far as I can tell, light and shadow do genuinely make a bit of a difference to how much you get spotted. If you stay in the darkness, you're much, much safer. Then we've got a locked window there. Who are you? Are you relevant? No, the person I'm looking for is still floors up on me. So then we've got, what's this? There's a red button here. I always like a red button. Turn off generator. Ooh. If I turn off the generator, does that mean power goes out? Let's try and see if it's also suspicious. Yep, it's suspicious. You can't get seen doing that. Fine. No, sorry. False memory syndrome. False memory syndrome. That definitely didn't just happen. Yeah, Alekhine's gun is a bit more generous on the save files than Hitman. As far as I can tell, you're allowed to save as much as you want. It's not telling me there's any limit whatsoever. So now, upstairs to the top floor. Let's see if I can figure out what that generator does or does not do that's important. So we're at the top floor right now. No one's suspicious of me, even though I do. I'm a Nazi officer who appears to be struggling with the concept of stairs and or banisters. Everyone gives me a little Nazi salute. And then, up here, we've got nothing I can anything I can interact with in here. Sort of maybe suspicious guy, but he's not too suspicious. He's just, like, paying attention. Then we've got, could open the door. Am I allowed to go in here, though? Ooh, are you? No, it's only that guy over there that's suspicious of this whole situation. Oh, he's doing some... Is he doing electroshock treatment or something? Is that what he's doing? Oh, yes, this is the nasty Dr. Eugenicist sort. So, logically, yes, it would make sense that he needs some electricity. So if I simply walk in there, I'm guessing it's bad. Are you always going to be here, by the way, or are you going to potentially walk away at some point? Oh, it also looks like my target might be in there with someone else, actually. It looks like there might be another... Yeah, there's a guard in there too. Okay, so it's not the easiest thing in the world. And you are... Oh, no, sorry. Were you about to walk out of this room? Aha, good. This is useful. So it looks like I'm mostly okay in here, but I need to figure out what this here... Ah! A switch hooked up to the chairs, I'm guessing. So in theory, I could be... No, I'm fine. Goodness sake. I'm not even thinking about going through that open door over there. Read wall note. Hang on, there's a wall note. Ooh. Phone number, 204 interrogation room. Ooh. I've just stumbled across something that could be of use. A nice wall note there. Yet stop going at me. It's fine. So the doctor over there, my target, does a little dance. He quite likes doing his jigs. Now I know the phone number to call into the interrogation room. So if I could just find myself a phone, there it is. That's a phone right there. Am I allowed to use the phone? Do you object? Okay, that gets that guy's attention. I put the phone down. We presumably cross each other on the stairs in a moment. Yep, so I've now got the only potential witness out of that room. Yes, Heil Hitler to you as well. Evil Nazi with an eye patch. Definitely not to be trusted. He'll go downstairs. This all works to my advantage. So I've now got the only witness out of that room. Beautiful. All right, back in here myself.
Heil Hitler!
So now I can walk in here because the doctor doesn't recognize me. So he puts the switch, and the switch is attached to what exactly? Because what does he do? Is the switch attached to... This, yeah, I need to figure out what can I do in this room. There's that chair. Yeah, fine. And then when do I turn the switch on? Because that guy's been wired into the electricity. Let's just watch this guy's routine. He goes over here. Looks at his handiwork. At some point, are you going to... Then you will turn the switch on. Fine. Start electrocuting some people. In a moment, he'll turn it back off again. After he does his little I'm electrocuting people dance. Turns it off. Oh, okay, so that guy comes back if I don't get it on the first rotation. Fine. So I don't quite see exactly the right timing to electrocute him. Because if I pull the switch, he sees it. You know, I would just straight up throttle that guy, but there is a guard right there, which is part of the issue. Alright, he goes away. Now get him quickly. Get him down, then just walk out. Oh no, no, oh no, he's died in mysterious circumstances that don't involve me whatsoever. Good. Alright, I'm going to be okay, in about 2 seconds, they're probably going to suspect the bloke that was just seen walking out of the room with the dead guy. But I'd say before that happens, we should probably leave. Okay, good. You've got to be, like, spot on with the timings. I didn't quite get the trick with the electricity there. I missed what was actually supposed to be going on there, but we've missed the trick. Okay, though, I think I know where I'm supposed to be going next. Okay, no, I'm fine. I'm not suspicious. I'm just Colonel Wiefenhauser. I led the 134th Air Battalion against those damn people that aren't us. Yes. Now, I'm guessing where I'm going now is the basement. The basement where I kind of saw previously. I'm guessing that's where the exit point is. We kind of sneak out by going underground. And now I know exactly how to get back to that. Because, yeah, you do the level so many times, you kind of just kind of get used to it. And I believe if that's going to be the well over there, if there's going to be like a well in this area, then I can climb down that and get into the... Where is it? Yes! It is right here. A well that leads me down into the basement. Climb. Straight down. No one in the basement, right? It hasn't spawned any people in. No. No, it has not. So now we simply run out. Beautiful. And whatever the equivalent of Silent Assassin is, too. Oh, and we also rescued someone, by the way. Is that what's happening? Hello. Who are you?
Are you the American? The one everyone keeps talking about?
Apparently no one noticed my amazingly obvious Russian accent.
You're the Russian. The one no one talks about.
Well, how did you hear about me then?
I was told the Russians were interested in Heinrich. Look, maybe we can work something out.
Looks like you're the only one who needs help here.
To hell with this. I have something you want. You just let me out of here.
Be more specific.
Documents. Heinrich was working on the serum. It's all in the folder. Formulas, reports of the tests they were working on.
Hurry up.
Alright, so now we've just freed a person. Where are we going now, by the way? Okay, we are going this way. Yellow means friendly. Out through the Bernie jet. Wait, hang on. Not this way, mind. Oh, do we have to turn off the gas in order to escape via this way? Oh, this feels like a terrible idea, but alright. Leave the place by turning off the gas and then really hoping it doesn't turn itself back on again. And there we go. Oh, not silent. I don't know what the highest rating is. I'm assuming there is a silent assassin. Noise, 10. Violence, 12. Accuracy, 100. Because I don't think I ever fired a gun. Professionalism, 90. I was never spotted, never listed. There was indeed one body found because I just throttled that guy at the end. 4 enemies were killed. Who are the 4? Guard at the beginning. Guard at the beginning. The 2 targets. Who was the 4th? Not sure. Instance kill. The accident, I'm guessing the poison is counted as an accident. 3 close encounters. Difficulty normal. And that gets me 213 reputation points. So again, like blood money, how well you do in a mission corresponds to how much currency you receive that you can spend on subsequent missions.
Command, I'm waiting for an explanation.
Herr Oberfuhrer, I do not have an explanation.
But of course, you don't have an explanation. How it happened that someone killed Heinrich and my staff sergeant while the damn American was still in his cell. I'm sending all of you to the tribunal.
Hello, Oberfuhrer. Could there be someone else working within the castle?
Really? Someone else working within the castle? At least someone here is working, you useless imbecile.
I assume they'd have to have the same conversation if I'd just gone in all guns blazing. Like, a spy in the castle?
Bring me the brandy.
There's no giant pile of bodies that points in that direction.
Comrade Major General, Colonel Strogoff, reporting.
At ease, Strogoff. And as always, no need to stand on ceremony. Please sit. Do you remember the Bergen operation? You mentioned Vincent Rambaldi in your report. Was it your first meeting with him?
Yes, sir.
Here he is. How do you like him? What can you say about him?
Inconspicuous, smart, cautious.
Smart, cautious, but taken captive.
That is correct, Comrade Lieutenant. Do you always interrupt the Colonel?
My apologies, Colonel. Permission to speak, sir?
I'm listening.
How exactly would you describe your relationship with Rambaldi?
It's good.
Good?
We were soldiers, potential enemies. I saved him, he gave me intel. Our relationship is good.
And what happened after that?
And apparently what happened next was we went on adventures together. And I think, ladies and gentlemen, I will show you a little bit more of that tomorrow. This is really rather good, isn't it? Yeah, it's proper old school Hitman stuff. Like, not quite Blood Money. There's a little bit about it that's almost more Hitman 2 or Hitman Contracts than Blood Money. The game isn't quite so forgiving about once you're in the right disguise, you can just go wherever the hell you want and do whatever the hell you want. There is a proper like little guard who will still look at you and go, not sure about that sort of thing, which, yeah, is much more kind of consistent with the older Hitman games. But I'll tell you what, I'll definitely do a little bit more yet. So there will be another part tomorrow. Along with Fallout 3, You Only Live Once, don't worry, you will get both of those. We'll do a two video Sunday again, which is always lovely. So, more tomorrow. But in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, I've been John, this has been many a true nerd, and this has been the really rather excellent Alekhine's Gun. Thank you very much, and goodbye. Good dodge, man. Question is, can you keep it up, cop? Oh, no, you can't. Ooh, nice. Oh, didn't quite get that one, though. We are going to the gun store in style. Oh, where's my partner? Oh, he's not here. Oh, so long, loser.